An interface is used to specify members that deriving classes must implement. They are declared with an interface keyword, followed by a name and a code block. Their naming convention is to start with a capital I and then to have each word initially capitalized. When declared in the namespace, their access level is internal by default, but can also be set to public. The code block can only contain signatures, and only those of methods, properties, indexers, and events. They cannot have any implementations. Instead, their bodies are replaced by semicolons. They also can't have any access modifiers, since interface members are always public. To show an example, we'll create an interface called iComparable with a single method named compare. We'll also create a class called circle with a field to hold the radius of the circle. In order to make this class implement our interface, we use the same notation as for inheritance. Notice that although the class can inherit from only one base class, it may implement any number of interfaces by specifying them in a comma-separated list after any base class. Because we implement iComparable, we must now define the compare method, which for this class will return the difference between the circle radiuses. The implemented member must be public in addition to having the same signature as the one defined in the interface. iComparable demonstrates the first usage of interfaces, which is to define a specific functionality that classes can share. It allows us to make use of the interface members without having to know the actual type of the class. We could, for example, create a simple method that takes two iComparable objects and returns the largest one. This method will now work for all classes that implements the iComparable interface, regardless of their type, since it only uses the functionality exposed through that interface. A second way in which we can use interfaces is to provide an actual interface for a class outwards. We then have the interface define the functionality that people using this class will need. They should then only use our class through this interface. This abstraction provides two benefits. First, it makes it easier to use our class, since we now only have access to the members that are relevant. And second, it makes our class more flexible, since we can now implement the class any way we want, as long as we follow the interface, without having to worry about breaking someone else's code.